kindness and goodness. But we are new to these qualities. Therefore, we practice them only out of necessity. Because I want to be happy, therefore I want to do something useful to you. That means happiness is given and taken. This is what is called the trade or commerce of goodness. So we begin to trade with our virtues and lead some thousands of lives. Again we are disappointed. And we meet with greater sorrow. Because if I do something good to you in expectation of something from you, suppose you deceive me, there is only grief. See, in this world, husband deceives wife and wife deceives husband. And the fellows live in sorrow and grief. This is because virtues are marketed in the stage of personality. So once again, life is understood as great pain, suffering and sorrow. And then experience teaches us that we have to make an approach to the real I am. Then automatically there is the breaking up of another egg and we come out as the bird once again. And this is called soul. So from personality consciousness, we enter into soul consciousness. This is the highest state of existence that a human being can understand. Because there is no disappointment in this state of existence. There is no sorrow and suffering. Man exists in constant joy and happiness. Because there is no state of expecting anything from anyone. Because you are with the Lord, you are like a Lord. When you are with the Lord, you are like a Lord. What is the nature of Lord? When you call a fellow a Lord, if he expects anything from anyone, you cannot call him a Lord. He is a weak fellow and a servant who expects anything from anyone. Even love, he gives only, he never expects. That's why he is not disappointed. That's why he is the Lord. And you are a Lord when you are with him. Because you know how to give love to others. And you have no mind to expect love from others. You know how to give happiness to others. And you have no nature to expect happiness from others. Because you are already happy. No one need give you happiness. When happiness is a light that shines from within yourself, how can anyone give you happiness? Can you give light to the flame? Because flame gives out light. You cannot give some light into the flame. Can you supply light to the sun? That is the nature of the I am in you. And nothing can be supplied to you when you are a yogi. And a yogi needs nothing from anyone and expects nothing from anyone. And when you want to become a yogi, an already existing yogi should be there by your side. A yogi can make you a yogi, just as a magnet can make an iron piece into a magnet. And what you require is the presence of a yogi. Such a fellow is called, that is, a teacher who is a spiritual master. How can we know he is a real guru or a false guru? We can never know. because he knows us and we does not know him. We do not know him. Just as the doctor can know a patient, and just as a patient cannot know who is a real doctor, always a guru knows, and no one can know who his guru is. We will consider about this a little later, and we should remember that we want a guru, and if someone gives you yoga, and if he expects you something from you, immediately you can understand that he is not guru. You cannot know a guru, but you can know a person who is not a guru. Suppose I teach you yoga, and I expect a big amount of money from you. Immediately you can be sure that I am a false guru. That is the first test to know who is not a guru. Whereas there is no test to know who is a guru. The guru should know us. But at the same time, we are not expected to hate anyone in this world. If someone wants to give you yoga and he wants some money from you, you can be kind to him, because the poor fellow wants some money. You can help him, but you can understand that he is not your guru. But treat him as a guru, because in the heart of everyone there is the guru, real guru. This should be your attitude if you want to have real yoga for yourself.